Hi, my name is Ivan.
You may have learned to classify a human or rose as living, rock as non-living. But why is this so? If you say that living is something that moves, but then flowing water can be called moving, right? That's not entirely true. Life has a set of properties that an organism has to follow to be called living.
And a wonderful discipline of science studies life in great detail. It is called biology. The word bio means living and logy means study. So biology means the study of living things. Anything which interacts with its environment uses energy and reproduces are known as living things. For example, we humans eat food to gain energy, feel and respond to our environment, and reproduce to make more of ourselves. Many other living things like insects, birds, and animals have the same properties like us, so they are all living organisms. But the question arises, how many types of living things are there, and how are they different from us? Biology is a field that answers these questions and many more questions related to living things. What is biology? There are seven characteristics that a living thing follows, and therefore we answer these in the vast field of biology. These are 1. Order. If you examine a rose from near, you will notice that it is ordered. The petals are rolled around each other with the center bearing seeds. This illustrates the highly ordered structure that typifies life. Living cells are the basis of this complex organization.
2. Reproduction. Organisms reproduce their own kind. A mother giant panda will always give birth to a panda, not a horse. We learned that from Kung Fu Panda 2. 3. Growth and development. Inherited information in form of DNA controls the pattern of growth and development of all organisms. You most probably look like your parents or close relatives, thanks to the genes. 4. Energy processing. We humans eat food in order to get energy. Food we eat has also eaten some other food in order to utilize its chemical energy stored, in order to power its chemical activities and chemical reactions. 5. Response to the environment. All organisms respond to environmental stimuli. This is why you laugh when you are tickled. 6. Regulation. Many types of mechanisms regulate an organism's internal environment, keeping it within limits to sustain life. This is also called homeostasis. A lemur sunbathes to help raise the animal's body temperature on cold mornings. 7. Evolutionary adaptation. A lioness camouflages in order to blend in with the savannah, so as to easily hunt down an animal. Such adaptations evolve over many generations. Some new concepts like genes and DNA have been introduced in this video. These will be explained in our upcoming videos. Use the video to answer the following question. You are in a community around a vehicle service bay. There is a mechanic who convinced the locals that a lorry is a living thing. There is an ongoing debate about this issue. You are a biologist who is interested in sensitizing the community. Prepare to sensitize the locals and give them the similarities and differences between a human being and a lorry. Clearly show that a lorry is a non-living thing. Thanks for watching.